他曾八次获奥斯卡最佳男主角提名，一部《闻香识女人》使他成为奥斯卡影帝。低微的出身曾使他的成名之路格外艰难。好莱坞电影明星艾尔·帕西诺。全身心投入到影片拍摄中的艾尔·帕西诺，感情生活一次次因此受到影响，和凯瑟琳·昆兰的情感也没能幸免。两人分手之后，不愿意享受孤独的帕西诺又回到了几度分分合合的戴安娜·基顿身边。
They really did have a thing together, you know. They're both the same wavelength. They were so similar. And, it was like siblings, you know.
1990年，艾尔·帕西诺和戴安娜·基顿一起被高价请回《教父》剧组拍摄《教父》第三集。片中迈克尔·科里昂和凯·科里昂破裂的婚姻好像在影射帕西诺和戴安娜·基顿之间又一次的紧张关系。
I know that Al has problems with commitments. To commit to something, I think he gets very claustrophobia. He needs air around and I think he's very scared of settle down.
在《教父》第一集当中相遇的帕西诺和基顿20年后终于彻底分手了。
I can tell you what he told me at the time. He says, I just lost my best friend. That's exact words.
情感上屡次失败的埃尔·帕西诺把心思更多地放到工作上。1991年，他拍摄了全明星阵容的《拜金一族》，同时将另一个不朽的形象搬上了荧幕。在刚刚出道、表演还十分青涩的克里斯·奥唐纳德衬托下，艾尔·帕西诺把一个脾气古怪的失明老军人演得让人刻骨难忘。
We were doing a rehearsal in the Waldorf Astoria, and it was just packed with people. And all of a sudden, Al just launched into something. I mean, I've never heard something so loud, and the entire lobby just stopped. And I looked over and like, who is this guy? And it's his voice out of nowhere. I mean, he's not that big of a guy. I don't know where he gets this voice, but it's amazing.
If I were the man I was 5 years ago, I'd take a flamethrower to this place.I've been around, you know. There was a time I could see, and I have seen boys like these, younger than these, their arms torn out, their legs ripped off. But there is nothing like the sight of an amputated spirit. There is no prosthetic for that.
那一年52岁的艾尔·帕西诺凭借影片《拜金一族》第三次得到奥斯卡最佳男配角提名，而电影《闻香识女人》让他第五次进入奥斯卡最佳男主角的角逐当中。
Oscar goes to Al Pacino and
It took him a few days to come down from that victory. He didn't think he'd be that affected by it, but he was. He was proud, and I think he felt a lot of people's positive energy.
I've been very lucky, and I've been lucky. I found desire for what I do early in my life, and I'm lucky because I had people who encouraged that desire, and from Lee Strasberg to my great friend and mentor Charlie Lawton, and I can't forget the kids out there who may be thinking tonight that if he can do it, I can do it. I want to thank the Academy for giving us a gift of encouragement, and this is a gift, a great gift to me. I thank you all, really. Thank you.
在艾尔·帕西诺逐渐适应了媒体和公众后，他也不再隐瞒自己的私人生活了。7年前，他和斯特拉斯伯格表演学院的教师简·图朗特相恋，并生下一个女儿的事情一直被隐瞒着。如今，他骄傲地把女儿朱莉·帕西诺带到了公众面前。
he's so proud of her, and he's such a good father, you know. It's what he really wanted, was kids all the time, you know. He just loved the idea of it. The marriage was the hard part, but the kids, man, no problem with that.
1997年，57岁的艾尔帕西诺开始花更多的时间和家人在一起，其中包括他的父亲萨尔瓦多和7岁的女儿朱莉，以及他生命中的一个新伴侣贝弗利·丹吉洛。在事业上，艾尔帕西诺已经成为好莱坞教父级的人物。在随后的几年中，他与新一代明星合作，又拍摄了《魔鬼代言人》《中间人》等多部电影。
I went on a record with you. You know what that means?
I think I do.
Nobody can touch you now. I'm your man. Jesus Christ couldn't touch you. So, keep your nose clean, be a good earner.Follow the rules, and who knows, maybe one day when they open the books, you get straightened out. Become a wise guy, a made guy. Come on, lift your glass. I die with you, darling. Anything happens, I'm responsible.
上一再突破的同时，艾尔帕西诺的生活中也有奇迹发生。60岁时，艾尔帕西诺的49岁的女友贝弗利·丹吉洛怀孕，这一消息让艾尔帕西诺狂喜不已。此间，他正在拍摄电影《中国咖啡》。2001年1月21日，他被授予金球奖的塞西尔·B·德米勒终身成就奖。4天后，他成了一对双胞胎的父亲。从一个孤独反叛的少年，到如今的奥斯卡影帝和美国偶像，艾尔帕西诺走过了一条漫长的路。在35年的职业生涯中，艾尔帕西诺在这个越来越商业化的行当里，让自己始终做一个艺术家。
Life is good to him, and he is humble enough to know he's lucky that life has given him these gifts. And he's in a good place now. He's in a wonderful place now.